Thanks for giving me a minute. I'm Rafael Solano. I'm Jane Villanueva's fiance. I just wanted to bring you my questionnaire.
It's a little late.
I know, and I know how it must have looked when I didn't show up for the appointment, and so I understand why you turned us down, but I just really
want... Can we talk outside for a second?
What are you doing here?
I didn't turn you down because you missed the appointment. Your fiance here went off on me. It might be prudent to have a conversation about Rafael's commitment to your family if you want me to marry you.
Are you serious?
Excuse me?
You have no idea what that man's overcome and sacrificed for our relationship, so don't you dare question his commitment. I mean, you can't even commit to a religion. What the heck is Unitarian anyway? Wow!
We're just gonna go.
Well, thank you for sticking up for me.
Are you kidding me after everything you've gone through? I won't have anyone doubting your commitment to me or our family. No one can be there all the time for everything. You're allowed to miss things to chase your dreams.
Thank you. You're a pretty great person. No wonder Alina wants your eggs.
Oh, turns out she doesn't want them anymore.
Why not? You have great eggs.
I know, that's what I said. But it just feels too complicated for her. She's gonna ask her sisters.
Well, that makes it easier.
Yeah, it really does. But man, all that baby talk made me think about our future baby and how I can't wait for that. So maybe we could talk about a timeline for adoption?
Well, I've actually also been thinking about that. And I realized that I definitely don't want more kids.
And there's our storm.
You don't want more kids? We talked. You said that you were open to adoption.
I was open to it. All that Lena talk just got me thinking, and I'm already spread so thin with work and three young and complicated children. And my life just feels full.
Wow, okay.
So what do we do now?
What do you mean? I told you, there are no deal breakers. We're getting married. And if you don't want more kids, then we won't have them.
I'm sorry. I wish I felt differently.
It's okay. I'm a little sad, but I get it. Besides, one of us may change our minds someday.
Yeah, you might.
And friends, one of them eventually would. I won't tell you who, but you can probably guess.
See, look how good we are communicating. That Reverend Fairdale is a big dumb bozo. Like I said, probably not a great fit. We can never go back to this church!
I love you.
I love you too, but I'm soaked, so can we get in the car?
Sorry.
God. Under the car!
Got him! Ah, never mind, don't got him!
Ah! Aha! Quick, get in the car before we get wet!
What happened?
Despite spending an average of 94 minutes a day in the gym, your father is sort of clumsy.
We weathered a storm.